All right, Michael, so here's what you have before you. You have the same housing data that we've looked at a couple of times before. I've, for the sake of readability, I've drawn over some of the data points so that they're easier to see. But this is exactly the data that we've always had, okay?
Okay.
Now, you'll notice that I marked one of them as green, because here's what we're going to do. I'm going to take the housing data you've got, I'm going to do some ensemble learning on it, and I'm going to hold out the green data point. Okay, so of the 9 data points, you're only going to learn on 8 of them. And I'm going to have that green data point as my test example and see how it does. Okay?
Okay, so that sounds like cross-validation.
It does. It's a cross-validation. Or you could just say, I've just put my training set and my test set on the same slot.
Okay.
Okay, Michael, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pick a random subset of these points. And just for the sake of the example, I'm going to pick 5 points randomly, and I'm going to do that 5 times. So I'm going to have 5 subsets of 5 examples. And by the way, I'm going to choose those randomly, and I'm going to choose them with replacement. So we're not going to end up in the situation we ended up just a couple of minutes ago where we never got to see the same data point twice. Okay?
Yeah.
All right. So 5 subsets of 5 examples, and then I'm going to learn a third-order polynomial. And I'm going to take those third-order polynomials. I'm just going to learn on that subset, and then I'm going to combine them by averaging. You want to see what we get?
Oh, yeah, sure.
So here's what you get, Michael. Here I'm showing you a plot over those same points with the 5 different third-order polynomials. Can you see them?
Yeah, right. There's like a bunch of wispy hairs.
Just like most third-order polynomials. And as you can see, they're kind of, you stare at them, you can see they're kind of similar, but some of them, they sort of veer off a little bit because they're looking at different data points. One of them, actually very hard to see because it's the only one like this, actually veers off like this because just purely randomly, it never got to see the 2 final points.
I see. But they all seem to be pretty much in agreement, like between points 3 and 4. There's a lot of consistency there.
Right, because just picking 5 of the subsets, you seem to be able to either get things on the end or you get things in the middle and maybe 1 or 2 things on the end, it sort of works out. Even the one that doesn't see the last 2 points still got to see a bunch of the first ones and gets this part of the space fairly right.
Cool.
Okay, so the question now becomes, how good is the average of these compared to something we might have learned over the entire data set? And here's what we get when we do that. So what you're looking at now, Michael, is the red line is the average of all of those 5 third-order polynomials. And the blue line is the fourth-order polynomial that we learned when we did this with simple regression a couple of lessons back. And you actually see they're pretty close.
Why is one of them a fourth order and one a third order?
Well, what I wanted to do is try a simpler set of hypotheses than we were doing when we were doing full-blown regression. So third order is simpler than fourth order, so I thought we would combine a bunch of simpler rules than the one that we had used before and see how well it does. You want to know how well it does?
I would.
Well, it turns out that on this data set, and I did this many, many, many times just to see what would happen with many different random subsets, it typically is the case that the blue line always does better on the training set, the red points, than the red line does, but the red line almost always does better on the green point on the test set or the validation set.
Interesting.
That is kind of interesting.
So, wait, so let me get this straight. It seems sort of magical. So it learns an average of third-degree polynomials, third-order polynomials, which is itself a third-order polynomial, but you're saying it does better by doing this kind of trick than just learning a third-order polynomial directly.
Yeah. Why might you think that would be? I have a guess. You tell me what you think.
Wow. So, well, I mean, you know, the danger is often overfitting. Overfitting is like the scary possibility. And so maybe by kind of mixing the data up in this way and focusing on different subsets of it, I don't know, somehow manages to find the important structure as opposed to getting misled by any of the individual data points?
Yeah, that's the basic idea. It's kind of the same thing, at least that's what I think that's a good answer. It's basically the same kind of argument you make for cross-validation, right? You take a bunch of random subsets, you don't get trapped by 1 or 2 points that happen to be wrong because they happen to be wrong because of noise or whatever, and you sort of average out all of the variance and the differences.
Hmm.
And oftentimes it works. And in fact, in practice, this particular technique of ensemble learning does quite well in getting rid of overfitting.
And what is this called?
So this particular version, where you take a random subset and you combine by the mean, is called bagging.
And I guess the bags are the random subsets?
Sure.
That's how I'm going to think of it.
That's how I'm going to think of it. It also has another name, which is called bootstrap aggregation. So I guess the different subsets are the boots.
No. Bootstrap usually refers to pulling yourself up by your bootstraps.
Yeah, I like my answer better. So each of the subsets are the boots, and the averaging is the strap. And there you go. So regardless of whether you call it bootstrap aggregation or you call it bagging, you'll notice it's not what I said we were going to talk about during today's discussion. I said we were going to talk about boosting. So we're talking about bagging, but we're going to talk about boosting. The reason I wanted to talk about bagging is because it's really the simplest thing you can think of, and it actually works remarkably well. But there are a couple of things that are wrong with it, or a couple of things you might imagine you might do better that might address some of the issues. And we're going to see all of those when we talk about boosting right now.